Hey guys, my name's Christian. I'm a watch fanatic. I just got my Sisu in. This is the automatic. I see a lot of videos. I haven't seen any for the Sisus yet, or Sisu, however you want to say it. This is the, I can't remember the model. You'll see when I open it, but it comes in an ammo can. I see a lot of videos like this, and sometimes I get frustrated because it takes so long to get to the point. So here's the ammo case. Opens up. Warranty card, not really much to see there, same as anywhere else. And then this is the watch. So, Swiss made, automatic, which obviously it's not running right now. Small note, within the first 2 hours of wearing this watch, the band broke. As you can see there, this little bit is supposed to be in that little bit. But Carol over at Sisu is sending me a new watch, so that's pretty cool. This one is, I want to say, 36 of 150 made. You can see the automatic movement in the back, which is really, really cool. This one is 100 meters, 330 feet, waterproof.
It's 11 o'clock.
Oh, that's my computer. Water resistant. It's a nice heavy watch. I couldn't tell you what it weighs, but I can compare it to some other watches so that'll make sense if you guys want to see that. So, here is my Tag Formula One. And it is a 44 millimeter case. It's a little small for my wrist because I have really big hands. Because I'm like Shrek. So that's that one. Let's take a look. It's a beautiful watch. The band is just ridiculous. Like, it's the coolest shaped band you can imagine. As soon as I have it on, I can't stop like looking at it. It's really cool. It's got the date. It's got the thingamadoodle right here, so you can change all the stuff and whatnot. Has about a 48-hour charge once you've wound it, and then with the automatic movement and so on and so forth. Here's my other Sisu. So this is the Bravado Quartz, I believe. So that gives you kind of a idea of what the difference is on these. So this is a 55 millimeter. So I want to say this is 50. I'm not 100% sure, but there's a good comparison there, so you can see. Oh, this one shouldn't be ticking. I leave them off on the batteries and whatnot. So that's that one. Let's compare it to another watch. This is a pretty common watch. One of my first ones I got a long time ago. Nixon 5130. Which, cool note, this one was never made. It's a sample watch. I'm not sure if you can see that. I have the camera on my head, so I'm not really much of a YouTuber. I just thought it would be cool to show people this. So if my video sucks, then yeah, no worries. Sorry about that. So, this is a 50mm watch, I believe. The Nixon 5130. It's a sweet watch. It's got my name engraved on it. Probably can't see that either. So, there's that one. And then I'll compare it to my last watch and one of my favorites. My girlfriend just got me a new band for this about a year ago. 2 years ago, probably. Jesus Christ. This is my Hamilton Khaki Below Zero. It's the watch from the Martian movie that Matt Damon wears. And this is probably one of my favorite watches, even though I hate the color black. Not black people, I love everyone, but I hate, because I work in the theater industry and the touring industry, and you always have to wear black, and I think black's like wearing a suit, makes everyone look the same. And that's a decent size watch, so this is about as small as I can go, 46 mil on this. That's about as small as I can go for my hands. So, I'm going to put one on each wrist, so you can get a kind of a look of the, we'll do the Tag, because not many people have the Sisu watch, so. This is the Tag on my wrist, and I'm 6'5", so I'm a pretty big guy, size 15 shoes, wedges, actually I just got a sweet pair of Patrick Ewing shoes as well, they're pretty sweet, no one would wear them, but, so this is, check this out, the difference on my hands, which obviously I can't clasp that because the clasp is broken, and that's what you're probably looking at. So if you're a bigger guy, like this Sisu is the perfect size. It's minus the band and my little complaint about that, which they remedied, and there's other ones on the way. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, it's a good watch. It's just beautiful. Like, it's made really well. Minus the band. I hate to keep saying that. Sapphire crystal. California design. Swiss made. You can see the little automatic movement through the bottom. So, yeah. That's the comparison. If you're looking to get a new watch. So, yeah, if you have any questions, I'd be more than happy to answer the questions. I'm not going to going to be like everyone else and say like and share, because I think a couple years from now that's all going to be gone and people are going to be humans again and actually talking to each other. That would be mind-blowing, wouldn't it? All right, guys. Appreciate it. See ya.